Hey guys, it's round two, game one. We have a lot of well-mannered people here. Pretty sweet. And this hand is very keepable. I mean, awkward if I don't get my third land, but let's give it a shot. I'm on the draw. There we go. Like magic. Stab wounds. So he's playing Azorius. So, oh sweet, Rakdos Shred Freaks all day, every day. Let's get it in, as they say. There's no Azorius counterspell, although that'd be pretty sweet. I miss the days of counterspells. I mean, I don't think I actually played a lot of Magic when counterspell was legal, but the idea of two mana counterspells is pretty sick. I miss it. And that's the end of the great experiment. So, Dead Reveler, I guess, is getting in there. I'm happy to build up my board a bit and then decide on what kind of removal spells I want to play. I'm chock full of goodness here, so I'm okay with that. I might use this as like a dead weight and then use this on something else. I don't know. But again, I'm happy to. Ooh, that's exciting. That I think will get killed, probably. Well, they both will, probably. Sunspire Griffin out? No. No attacks, eh? Splatter Thug, maybe? Choices. Do I kill his Sunspire Griffin and run in with the Shred Freak? Do I play Splatter Thug? I think the answer is play Splatter Thug. And wait. More mana would be nice, actually. He's building up quite the estate there of land, and I can't really dump my hand here, which is very frustrating. So he goes in for four. That's fine. And then my timely removal spell might be nice if he drops something big. An action injunction. That's kind of annoying. And a courier? Ugh. It's annoying. I think here I play Shred Freak and swing with team. It's probably what I'm gonna do. Play Shred Freak, swing with team. There we go. Trades off a Shred Freak, that's fine. He takes five, he goes to 13. Ooh. 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 That's not good for me. That's 16 all. Maybe I should start removing some of these guys. Sunspire Griffin might be one to remove. Yeah, I'll take it. Can't do anything else. Here, I have to run in, I think, with everything. If he's got like an some sort of a teleportal or electric, or, not electricery, teleportal or the tapping everyone card, that would be pretty bad. I mean, he's paused at combat, so he's thinking about it, about tapping down my team, which would be pretty devastating, I'd say. He doesn't. Well, I've got the Augur Spree in case he has some crazy combat trick. I think I'm happy to trade those. It's fine with me. He has a trick. Top of Owner's Library. That's frustrating. What do I do here? What do I do here? Stab wound his soul sworn spirits. These guys are gonna kill me at the end of the day. Yes, they are. Augur Spree, his Sunspire Griffin. Or play Sewer Shambler. I think I can take one more hit. Let's see. Let's see what happens. Next turn, I might have to remove something. I go down to 8. What's he got here? He's got the Tapper. I think he's thinking about it. All right. Well, I mean, it's clearly that I have some sort of trick. Yeah, let's kill the Sunspire Griffin here. Probably should have done it end of turn. Well, whatever. So I go down to 2, 6. He's got something going on. I'm very curious what this is. What on earth does he have? Another one. Yikes. Goes to 6. I'll kill it. I'll kill it now. And then I have stab wound for the last few damages, last few bits of damage that he might have. I think I'm in a good spot. I mean, again, the stab wound on whatever random stupid thing he has is going to be pretty good for me, I think. Yes. Now the thing I have to worry about is Essence Backlash, so I got to play around that, I think. Oh, nope, didn't have to. So my removal was good enough. You could argue I could have used the removal faster. These Deviant Glees become less good. Versus someone with a lot of bounce. So maybe another Grim Roustabout and another Launch Party? That seemed to do some good stuff for me in the past. Removal is always good. This hand's fine. Two drop, three drop, all the land I need. Don't need to mulligan it. I said all the land I need. I don't really think giving me another swamp was what I wanted here, but there we go. That's what I'm talking about. Solid two drops, solid three drops. This is a game I can play. Some removal. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm feeling it. I'm feeling the sexy right now. Attack. Thank you. The leg is annoying. I would like to put on a counter there. Yeah. Oh, Dramatic Rescue. Okay, fine. If he has a Dramatic Rescue like that, then I'm A-okay with that. Totally fine with me. So here is again the question of, do I play Dark Revenant or do I play a 3-drop? I think in this setting, I would rather keep the Dark Revenant back. Maybe. I think I just want to play out my dude again. Yeah. Because the next turn I get a 2-drop, fine. I play 2, I still have some stuff to play. Eyes in the Skies is fine with me. I am not worried about Eyes in the Skies at all. That's not going to get him there anytime soon. So So I'm wondering maybe a court hussar. Wow. Okay. Well, he's got a lot of bounce. I'll give him that. That is kind of annoying. By kind of, I mean very annoying. He has a lot of bounce. Too much, I would say. But who am I to judge? Right? You know what? Screw it. Let's put the Dark Revenant out there. I think that slows down his attack. Or it doesn't. Interesting. So clearly he's got the Swift Justice card, and I'm going to let him attack in. Doesn't bother me. And Courier. Courier. And Fairy Imposta. Bouncing a bird token or a courier? Bounces a... Okay. Don't really care about that too much. So, what do I do? 2-3 drops? Yeah. I'm happy to draw Dark Revenant for the rest of the game if I'm trading off guys. He's not going to let me do that. That's fine. Yes. And I have handful of removal. That's pretty good for me. Sure, I'll take 6. Or 4, I mean. That is getting stab wounded very badly. Very, very badly stab wounded. And we swing in. He will take 2, 4, 7. Two, four, seven, 9 damage. Okay. So next turn I take 2, 4, 5, 6, and then 2, 4, 5, 6. I might need a stab wound something. The question is, do I stab wound this or... Because if he has something that taps guys or a teleportal or something, so 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 almost kills me, right? So maybe I should take out the Fairy Imposters, or should I just save it? So if he has it, if he has a tap thing, he swings in once, he swings in twice, I'm dead. 2, 4, 5, 6. Actually, but then if I kill it, it's not that bad. He plays another guy, though. I don't know. I think I'm going to hold on to it. It's questionable whether I should have done something there. The fact that he didn't block with the Crossdown Courier means I think he's thinks he's got it. He probably had some pump too, right? So, let's see. Maybe I should have killed something. Azorius Charm. Oh, shit. Really? Wow. Okay. Goes up to 10. 10 life. 3, 6, 8, 10. And he has Singer Songbirds. That's annoying because that's 2 blockers. Another dead reveler. So how do I play this? I want, man, the stab wound is not doing any damage the way I want it to. So blocks, I can take 2, keep this guy as a blocker, so I can block these 2 guys. He's going to have to block like those 2. I mean, I'll run in with everything and see what happens. Except for the Dark Revenant. Dark Revenant's going to stay back. He has to block 2 guys. Easily, right? Blocks 1 guy. Uh-huh. So this guy comes down as a blocker of the ground. So blocks, I take 3, and then I stab wound whatever he drops next. Might be okay. If he has some sort of tapping, I'm dead. An action junction is pretty bad for me. Probably should have killed something then. Damn it. Oh, I'm at 5. Might wait. I'm not dead yet, right? Oh, that kills me. Yeesh. Okay, that was bad. I probably should have stabbed him something. Get the imps in? They're not very good against him. Nah, I think it's fine. I just play first and win. Nope, this looks good. Win and play first and win, right? That's always the strategy to win the game. Yeah, the race was close. I probably should have stabbed him a lot earlier. I would have saved a lot of damage there. Just sucks. I wanted to get like a little bit of extra oomph out of it. He just never had anything with more toughness, which is frustrating as heck. But this hand looks okay. No traditionally good 3-drop, but that's all right. Grimrush about will do, I think. Oh, or the traditional 3-drop will do. Sure. Dead Reveler, let's do it. So land would be awesome, actually. Just so I can get my Blood-Free Giant out there. But if not, life is okay. Ah, shit, the dramatic rescue is so annoying. Okay. Sweet. Can't complain about that. What's he got here? Always stopping on the combat step. Very annoying. Bring it. What you got? What you got? Eyes in the Skies? No, he has 3 mana. Can't do that. All right, Blood-Free. Get in there. Cancel? No. 5-4 Trampler is pretty sweet. Not much he can do about that, I would imagine, unless he bounces it. And we wait. What does he have? 4 mana? Rune Wing. Rune Wing is fine. It's not amazing, but probably stab wound it. Play a Roustabout, attack for 7. He gets a free card, but at least I don't lose anything. I'm fine with that. I'm not going to make the mistake of not stab wounding his guy. Doesn't look like he has a lot of high toughness guys anyways, so get your free card. And Roustabout. And I win. Sweet. Okay, thanks for watching. See you in the finals. 8-4 finals, baby.